हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक इन इंग्लिश ग्रामर क्लास। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द फर्स्ट टेंस, दैट इज सिंपल प्रेजेंट टेंस। लेट्स फर्स्ट डिस्कस द यूजेस ऑफ दिस टेंस। रेगुलर हैबिट्स आर डेली रूटीन। यूज द सिंपल प्रेजेंट टू एक्सप्रेस द आइडिया दैट एन एक्शन इज रिपीटेड आर यूजुअल। वी यूज इट फॉर रेगुलर हैबिट्स आर डेली रूटीन, समथिंग विच वी डू ऑन डेली बेसिस, समथिंग विच आर आवर हैबिट्स। So in order to express those habits or those daily routine, we use simple present tense for it. The action can be a habit, it can be a hobby, a daily event, or something that often happens. It's not necessary that something which happens daily, so we use simple present for it. No, we can use it for something which maybe happen weekly, something which happen monthly, something which happens at a regular interval of time, like it happens repeatedly. So all those actions or all those habits, all those situations, we would express it in simple present tense. Like here as an example, if we say I go to school, so obviously on daily basis we go to school, so this sentence would be expressed in simple present tense. And if we say that I wake up early in the morning, so here this sentence also shows simple present tense. Why? Because it is our habitual actions that we are doing at regular interval. So it's not necessary that each and every day I wake up early. Maybe on Sundays I wake up late, but still we express it in simple present tense. Why? Because it is a regular habit or a daily routine of ours. Here you can see the examples of this tense. I play soccer. So here you can see that it is a regular habit of that person. The school opens every morning at 7 a.m. So here again, it is a habitual action, it is a routine that the school opens every morning at 7 a.m. He always forgets her bag. Here it is her his habit that he always forgets her bag. So it's not necessary that daily he forget her bag. Maybe at like after few days he forget her bags, that's why we are saying he always forgets her bag. Every 12 months the earth circles the sun. Here it is clearly mentioned that after every 12 months, like it's a lot of time, every 12 months, 12 months mean 1 year. So something which is even happening yearly, so those are also a habitual action or something the actions with that are happened repeatedly. That's why we expresses such type of sentences in simple tense as well. Every 12 months the earth circles the sun. So here you can see that as it happens after 1 year, but still we expresses it in simple present tense. Facts are generalization. The simple present can also indicate the speaker believes that a fact was true before, is true now, and will be true in the future. As I told you, it also included a scientific truth, because we know that it such type of true sentences are true before, they are true now, and they will be true in the future, because they are scientific facts. They are proved by the scientists, they are scientifically proven that those sentences are those statements are those situations. So we expresses all those situation or those actions in simple present tense. It is not important if the speaker is correct about the fact. Here, like, it's not necessary that you have to prove it. You have to prove the fact. Simply we believe because we have heard something and we are repeating it, so we expresses it in simple present tense. It is also used to make generalization about people or things. As like something, at times we just say that all the children are naughty. So it's not necessary that all the children will be naughty. Maybe there are some such type of children which they are good children, but still it is a generalization that we are saying that yes, usually all the children are naughty. So such type of generalization about people or things are also expressed in simple present tense. As an example, you can see cats like milk. Cats like milk. So it is a generalization. It's not necessary that it would be a fact or it is a truth, but it is a generalization about cats which are accepted by each and every person. So that's why we expresses it in simple present tense. Caracas is the capital of Venezuela. Here obviously it is accepted by all because we know that Venezuela country has this capital, so this would be expressed in simple present tense. Windows are not made of wood. Here again it is a generalization, it's not necessary because we have windows which are made up of wood as well, but it is just a general fact. It's not necessary that it would be acceptable by the speaker himself, but it's just they are just expressing general statements, so they are all expressed in simple present tense. Scheduled events in the near future. Speakers occasionally use simple present to talk about scheduled events in the near future. Something which is going to be happen or which we already having a plan for it, so we express it in simple present tense. Like this is mostly commonly done when talking about public transportation, but it can be used with other scheduled events as well. Mainly it is used for public transportation. An example, it will be more clear to you with looking at the example. The bus leaves tonight at 6 p.m. So the bus is yet to come, like it we would travel in it, but here they express the bus leaves tonight at 6 p.m. which shows that something which is already scheduled and it would happen, so that's why we express it in simple present tense. When do we board the plane? The party starts at 8 o'clock. The party is not yet started, but as it is scheduled to be started at 8 o'clock, so that's why we express it in simple present tense. The simple present is used with adverbs. Like here are some particular adverbs which are used in simple present tense in order to show the habituality or the routine of these actions. Like here you can see, I always come to school by car. So it's not necessary, maybe at times I didn't come by car, so still we express it in simple present tense. Why? Because it's a habitual action. I always come to school by car. So here the adverb always is used. I don't come here very often. Here adverb often is used. He usually eats breakfast at 7 a.m. Sometimes I go to party. She rarely cooks. He is never late for class. They sleep early every day. So these are all habitual actions and we express it. These are happening with regular interval of times. That's why we express it in simple present tense or present indefinite tense. We have certain rules for it, grammar rules. To form the simple present, we add s to the infinitive of the verb in the third person singular. As I have already told you, it have this type of tenses has a very simple and a very basic structure. The subject, then verb, and then object. It is the basic structure of the simple present tense. But there are exceptional cases. Like here you can see they are saying that with third person singular, he, she, it are third person singular name, whether it is a name of something, someone or something. So we added s or es with the verb. Okay, an example, you can see, I live, I sing, they live, they sing. But whenever we are changing these sentences, we are changing the subject of these sentences. He, she, it lives, he, she, it sings, then we would add s with the verb. But when the verb ends in o, double s, sh, ch, or x, we add es with it. Whenever these words ends with these alphabets, then we use yes with it. Like here you can see, I go, he, she, it goes. I kiss, he, she, it kisses. I watch, he, she, it watches. I wash, he, she, it washes. I fix, he, she, it fixes. So here you can see with all these cases we added yes with it. A consonant followed by y, the y changes into ie, and we add s. Whenever a vowel is whenever a consonant is followed by y. So, consonant means those alphabets which are not vowels. So whenever they are followed by y, so this y would be changed into I, and we would add just es with it. Here you can see, I study, he or she studies. We have used es. vowel followed by y, we just add s. Whenever a vowel is just followed by y, so we didn't change it into I, and we just add s with it. Like here you can see I play, so a is vowel, so we didn't change this into I, this y into I, and we just add s with it. He or she plays. To form the negative and the interrogative, we need the auxiliary verb to do in the present simple. This means we have to add es in the third person singular, he, she, it, while the main verb will be used in infinitive. Here we have another rule. Whenever we are changing those positive sentences into negative or interrogative sentences, so we add just a helping verb to it, that is do. But you know, whenever we are not using s or es with the verb, so we use do as a helping verb with I, you, we, they, and plural. We didn't use s or es, so we would use do with it. Like here you can see, do I like, do you like, do they like, I don't like, you don't like, they don't like. But whenever in those cases in which we were adding s or es with the verb, like in third person singular, he, she, it, or singular name, we uses does with it. Does she like, does he like, does it like, she does not like, he does not like, it does not like. Here you can see that with like we used s with it, but here we just omit that s and we uses it with the do, and it becomes does. Like when we use does in negative or interrogative sentences as a helping verb, then no need to add s or es with the verb. Like here you can see, does she like, you can't say it like this, that does she likes. No, again you wouldn't use s or es with the verb because it is already used with the helping verb. Here you can see the structure of affirmative, negative and interrogative sentences. Subject plus verb plus complement, and in bracket they have given that add e or es to the third person singular. Negative structure of negative, subject plus auxiliary, do or does. Auxiliary mean helping verb. Helping verb do or does would be used plus not, plus verb, plus complement. Interrogative, auxiliary, do or does, the helping verb would came at the start of the sentence, then plus subject, then plus verb, and plus complement. And don't forget to put this sign of question mark at the end of interrogative sentences. Complement is the rest of the sentence, or it is a statement about subject. So this was the structure of affirmative, negative and interrogative sentences. Here is an example. You can see I live, I don't live, do I live, you live, you don't live, do you live, he lives, he doesn't live, does he live, she lives, she doesn't live, does she live, it lives, it doesn't live, does it live, we live, we don't live, do we live, you don't live, do you live, they live, they don't live, do they live. So here you can see that where we have to use s or es, and where we have to use does as a helping verb, and where we have to use do as a helping verb. Like here you can say in an affirmative sentence we didn't have any helping verb in it, but in negative and interrogative we have do or does as a helping verb or auxiliary verbs along with the main verbs. And always remember to put a question mark at the end of interrogative sentences. Hope this lecture would be clear to you. In my next class we will discuss another type of tense. Your homework for today is that you have to write 5 sentences of affirmative, negative and interrogative sentence of simple present or present indefinite tense. See you in my next class.